Hi, everybody. Welcome back to the front room. I'm Kai and I'm here with my dad today.
Hi, guys. Thanks for dropping in.
I put a poll up today and the people have spoken. We're going to be reacting to one of the most popular rap songs of the 2000s, I think.
Okay, we're back into the 2000s.
Yep, and it's coming from a rapper called The Game.
Okay, good.
Good. Yeah.
What can I say?
Well, I'll tell you. Maybe this yeah. could explain it. He's a contemporary of 50 Cent.
Oh, okay.
Even though The Game was born in Compton, so West Coast, and 50 Cent was born in New York.
Mm-hmm.
I believe in the Bronx. They are stylistically sort of similar, and they collaborated a lot. And yeah, so The Game. I'll do a brief history. He was born in Compton, same as Kendrick Lamar,
mm-hmm.
and some other NWA members.
Mm-hmm.
And he released his first debut mixtape, which is sort of hard to explain what a mixtape is exactly, but in 2004. And then he got picked up or noticed by Dr. Dre, who's part of NWA and has had a very successful solo career,
mm-hmm.
and he got signed to Aftermath Records, and he came out with this album called The Documentary, which this song is from.
Mm-hmm.
The song we're going to be covering today is called Hate It or Love It.
Okay.
It's one of my earlier rap songs that I really loved when I was younger.
Yeah, okay. Nice.
Yeah, and just some other facts about him. He was in the foster care system for like 6 years. His family was pretty dysfunctional. And in 2001, he actually got shot 5 times and he was in a coma for 2 days.
Wow.
Yeah.
It's funny. He worked with 50 Cent and you told me that he was shot 9 times.
Yeah.
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 Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
He was in a coma. Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Oops, so
my cord, Kai, just came out.
Oh, okay. There you go.
Thank you. It's good to have a technician in the house.
Yeah. Okay, so this is the album cover. The Game.
The Game. The documentary.
Yeah. Came out in 05. Massive album. And we're going to get straight into it. It's called Hate or Love It.
I kind of like that. Cover. Yeah. Are these, can I ask you a quick question?
Yeah.
Are these like the chrome wheels that were that Lupe Fiasco referred to in his song?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Good. Thank you.
All right. Here we go. Okay. Hate it or love it.
Hate it or love it.
Yeah. Let's take them back. Uh-huh. Coming up, I was confused. My mommy kissing a girl. Confusion occurs coming up in the cold world. Daddy ain't around, probably out committing felonies. My favorite rapper used to sing, check out my melody. I wanna live good, so shit, I sell dope for 4 figures. One of them gold ropes. Nana told me if I pass, I get a sheepskin coat. If I can move a few packs, I get the hat. Now that'd be dope, tossed and turned in my sleep that night. Woke up the next morning, niggas have stole my bike. Different day, same shit, ain't nothing good in the hood. I run away from this bitch and never come back if I could. Hated or love it, the underdogs.
So that's 50 Cent starting off the song there. And now it's The Game right now. I'm Raps MVP, and I ain't going nowhere, so you can get to know me. Hated or love it, the underdogs
on top. Yeah.
And I'm gonna shine, homie, until my heart stop. Go ahead, envy me. I'm Raps MVP, and I ain't going nowhere, so you can get to know me. Nick. On the grill of my lowrider, guns on both sides, right above the gold wires, I'll 4-5 them. Kill a nigga on my song and really do it, that's the true meaning of a ghostwriter. 10 G's to take your daughter out of Air Forces. Believe you me, homie, I know all about losses. I'm from Compton where the wrong colors be cautious. One phone call, I had your body dumped in Marcy. I stay strapped like car seats, been banging since my little nigga Rob got killed for his Barclays. That's 10 years, I told Pooh in 95, I'll kill you if you try me for my Air Max 95s. Told Banks when I met him, I'm a ride, and if I gotta die, I'd rather homicide. I ain't had 50 Cent when my grandmama died. Now I'm going back to Cali with my Jacob on. See how time flies.
The underdogs on top. And I'm gon' shine, homie, until my heart stop. Go ahead, envy me.
I'm Raps MVP, and I ain't going
this
nowhere.
Chorus so is very catchy.
Yeah, I love how they toss it back and forth between each other.
Yeah. I'm Raps MVP, and I ain't going
nowhere so you can get to know me. I'll pause it there.
Yeah, their voices work great together.
So well.
Don't they?
So well.
Yeah, they both have this tough kind of attitude or feel to their voices.
Yeah, I mean, it's certainly deep. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, I love their voices. I just like the quality of their vocals.
Yeah. What do you think of the music?
Oh, it's okay. It's connected again. Pardon me?
What do you think of their music?
Oh, I love it. Yeah, the opening was really good. Gosh, I just can't remember what I heard.
Yeah, well... But,
yeah, it was fantastic.
Yeah, well...
Before the rap started up?
Yeah.
Really good. It almost sounded... I keep saying this a lot. It almost sounded retro. Yeah. Almost like...
Nostalgic.
Almost like Isaac Hayes or something.
Yeah.
You know?
I know what you mean.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Really, really nice.
And when that bass kicks in, it's so
nice. Oh, yeah. That's so good. Yeah. The bass came in pretty early there. It was really
I love some of the vocal samples, too. So I'm going like... in the background. Just makes it so much nicer. I love the little vocal samples like that.
Mm-hmm.
I also think there's some guitar in there and those glorious... trumpets at the end of four bars.
Oh, okay. Will that continue in the next?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to listen for the trumpets then.
Yeah.
Yeah, neat. I find it neat that rap music, the last song we listened to by The Far Side, they used some sax and there was some, I don't know if they were trumpets, some kind of brass instrument in there.
Yeah.
I find it cool that rap artists like to use those types of instruments.
Yeah, it has a great effect.
Not so much the sax, but other brass instruments. Yeah, it does. It's really neat.
There's a certain triumphant feel of using them, oftentimes.
There is.
But also, it can also be very deflated.
And they're used sparingly.
Yeah.
Just a little bit, but it really adds some pizzazz to the song.
Yeah, totally. Shall we keep going?
Yep.
Okay. And I ain't going nowhere, so you can get to know me. Hated to love it, the underdogs on top. And I'm gonna shine, homie, until my heart stop. Go ahead, envy me. I'm Raps MVP. So it's sort of their rags to riches story. From the beginning to the end, losers lose, winners win. This is real, we ain't got to pretend. The cold world that we in, it's full of pressure and pain. Enough of me, nigga, now listen to game. Used to see 5-0 throw the crack by the bench. Now I'm fucking with 5-0, it's all starting to make sense. My mom's happy she ain't gotta pay the rent. And she got a red bow on that brand new Benz. Waiting on shot money to land, sitting in the range. Thinking how they spent $30 million on airplanes. When his kid's starving. Pockets going and Brenda still throwing babies in the garbage. Oh. Wanna know what's going on like I hear Marvin. No school books, they use that wood to build coffins. Whenever I'm in the booth and I get exhausted, I think, what if Marie Baker got that abortion? I love you, Ma. And I'm gonna shine, homie, until my heart stop. Go ahead. That last part of that verse is amazing. And I ain't going nowhere, so you can get to know me. Hated to love it, the underdogs on top. And I'm gonna shine, homie, until my heart stop. Go ahead, envy me. I'm Raps MVP, and I ain't going nowhere, so you can get to know me. That percussion is so good.
Oh, it sure is.
It opens up right here. Has lots of space. And then the hats come in right here.
And I love that bass. It works so well with the percussion.
Yeah.
Wow, this is really excellent.
Yeah, nice. Wow,
it's really... Man, I have to listen to this song like 5 or 6 times. There's so much going on here.
Yeah. Well, I know what you caught in the last verse there.
He mentions Pack is gone. Brenda's still throwing babies in the garbage.
Yeah.
Yeah. From the earlier reaction did. I want to know what's going on. Like I hear Marvin Gaye.
Yeah.
This part, no school books. They use that wood to build coffins. That's quite a line, eh?
Yeah. Which is, which is scary. I mean, I only sort of recently, the past, or maybe 3 years ago or something like that, found out how the money that goes into the schools doesn't come from a larger area. It comes directly from the taxes from that region.
Yeah.
So when they do that, they're creating a system that does not improve, right? Because
no, it's a
they can't bring in money, and they can't fund the schools, and the cycle continues. So I think that's a really, really great.
That is a truly insane way to fund schools.
Yeah,
absolutely crazy.
Yeah,
yeah. I don't know who Marie Banker is.
Yeah,
do you know
Marie Baker? I think.
If Marie, it says Banker.
Oh,
it could be a mistake. I think it's Baker, sometimes lyrics. Screw things up
with yeah.
I think if Marie Baker got that abortion.
So that's tying to that
I think Pac what if
reference, right? The Brenda situation. But the way it ties in is because Marie Baker is his mom. So whenever he's this song is about his rags to riches story. In the beginning, 50 Cent talks about how he wanted all these things, you know, some material possessions. I want to get this chain around my neck. Maybe if I sell drugs, then I can get those things. And now they finally made it, right? So in the chorus, they're saying, "And you should get to know me because I'm sticking around. I'm at the top now." But to get there, you know, he's got to be in the studio all the time making this music. And when he gets exhausted, he thinks, "I'm just going to keep persevering because the fact is my mom didn't have to have me. She sacrificed to have me."
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to like make the most of it.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
It's nice.
Yeah.
Nice sentiment.
Yeah, really it is.
Yeah, it is. Wow. Yeah, there was a lot going on with these lyrics. You know, once again, I'd have to go back and listen to this again.
Mm-hmm.
But I just like, as the lyrics flew by, I thought, wow, that's amazing. Oh, that's fantastic. Putting those words together and just that image.
Yeah.
Of this and that. And he really painted a really, to me anyway, vivid picture of what it was like starting out in a tough environment.
Yeah.
It just.
Totally.
Yeah.
It's good that you point that out because I think both of them, they don't try to extend themselves with their poetry in a complicated way. And they just, similar to Pac, they sort of just say how it is.
Yeah.
And it's really powerful. You pair that with a great voice and
yeah,
and you can't go wrong, right?
No, you can't. It's in some ways quite straightforward. So, but as you say, because it's somewhat straightforward, it hits you right away.
Yeah,
there's no wondering what does he mean by this or that.
Not so much. Yeah.
Yeah.
So this song is, with that chorus being so damn catchy, right?
It's such a good chorus.
Yeah. This is his most popular song. And the album that it came from is good. Some songs I don't really care for, but mm-hmm. others I do. But this is probably my favorite song of his.
So is 50 Cent involved with other songs on this album? Do you know?
Oh, I forget. I think he is.
Yeah.
I think he is, yeah.
Yeah. I'm not mentioning so many of the lyrics, but it's so good.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
I'm glad. Maybe I can show you some more of the game stuff, more of the 50 Cent
stuff. Oh yeah, I want to hear the game.
Yeah,
and 50 Cent. Yeah, so he's from Compton.
Yeah,
it almost feels to me kind of similar. Yeah, just the overall emotion or feeling to what 50 Cent was singing.
With many men?
Rapping about, yeah, with many men. It's not the same, but like I don't know the difference really between East and West Coast, although I know that we've listened to some West Coast, and it does feel a little bit more laid back.
Totally.
And kind of
just that G-funk, right?
Yeah. But this to me almost sounds like a East Coast take. But that's my untrained ear.
Mm-hmm. You know? The East Coast is a bit grittier.
Mm-hmm.
The drums are bigger and punchier, but this song with that sample and some of those vocal sounds, that it sounds East Coast to me. It sounds more more soulful than some of the New York stuff.
It sounds more East Coast to you?
Oh, sorry, West Coast.
West Coast.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. Fantastic. I love this. I want to hear this as soon as we're done here. I think I'm going to go upstairs and. Lock myself away and listen to this a couple of times. It's really good.
Yeah. Glad you liked it.
Yeah, I did.
Well, thanks for watching, everybody. I'm going to be putting more polls up, and you can vote on those. Just go to our YouTube profile and click on the community tab, and you can do it from there.
Thanks for stopping in, guys. See you next time.
See ya.